What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name's David, and today I'm going to be reviewing the new Renogy 50 amp DC to DC charger with MPP solar charging. Before we get too far into the review, I wanted to talk to you guys about my simple solar guide. If you guys are having trouble, if this is your first time, I'd highly recommend downloading it. I've had a lot of great feedback from people who are just building out their van, their RV, their trailer, or off-grid solar cabin, and it's been really useful for them. So I will link it below and up in the corner. So go ahead and check that out. Also, if you are buying anything from Renogy, use the discount code MADETOTRAVEL. It doesn't cost you anything more, and you'll get an extra discount when you go to checkout. So this is the model that me and Kaylee have been using. I've been using this for almost 3 years now. It's been awesome. I love it. It's a 2-in-1 component, so you don't have to install both a solar charger and a DC to DC charger. You can just use one, and it worked great. My only complaint was it does prioritize solar, which is green energy. I'm a fan of it, but when you need that power from your alternator, when you're driving, it's nice to just always have 50 amps going in regardless of what the solar is. So previously, if you were getting say 10 to 15 amps of solar while you were driving, this actually would only pull a max of 25 amps from the alternator. That's why I had a shutoff switch for my solar. So while we were driving, I would turn off the solar and then this would pull 50 amps. I think it's smarter, and I'm pretty sure because it has Bluetooth, you can adjust the settings for that. If you have, say, 5 amps coming in on solar, you can adjust the controller to just turn off and start pulling everything from the alternator. Amazing. The other big factor is the size. This is actually insane. Like, this is probably half the size of this one. It is slightly bigger than an iPhone. That's so impressive. This is gonna take up hardly any space in my solar cabinet. It also appears to be very well built and very sturdy. It also has an IP67 rating. Literally everything about this controller is better than this one. This one can also work with 12 volt or 24 volt. It works with any type of battery. Another huge improvement with this model is it can work with 720 watts of solar and 50 volts. The previous model could only go up to 25 volts, which was really low. And now a lot of solar panels these days are higher than 25 volts. It's on sale on Renogy's website for $440 US, but be sure to use that discount code MADETOTRAVEL. And it also comes with a 3-year warranty. To go over quickly what comes in the box, you have the charger, which actually comes with the cables for the hookups. And so what they've also provided is the wire connectors that go on the ends of these cables. And then there is also, as with all Renogy components, a temperature sensor. I'm probably not gonna be installing this because I have a heated battery which manages temperature itself. All of these cables are actually nicely labeled. The yellow one is your PV plus, your positive cable for your solar. The black one is gonna be your negative connection. The brown one is gonna be your out positive connection. And then the red one is gonna be your alternator connection. You have your little port here to plug in your temperature sensor. So the install is gonna be really straightforward. Beside the wire connections here, you have your CAN communication port. So if you have other Rego components or the Renogy One core, this is where you can connect them. On the other side here is the Bluetooth module. And then beside that, you have your indicators. So you have your solar, you have your alternator. Those will light up once when you're getting power from solar alternator. And then you have a battery light. And then beside that, you have your type. There's a little button right here where you can click to switch between lithium, gel, lead acid, whatever battery type you might have. The best tips I have when installing this are make sure you have put all the proper fuses in the right locations. For the wire for your alternator, you want to install a fuse on the battery itself if you're connecting to the battery. Some people do connect straight to the alternator, so you want to make sure that that fuse is located as close to the power source as possible and don't locate the fuse near the charger. The other thing is making sure your solar components are fused. You can install inline MC4 connector fuse, which is what I have and a lot of people tend to go with, on the positive wire. The last fuse that you're going to install is on the positive cable that will be going to your positive bus bar. My fuses are 60 amp for the positive, 60 amp for the alternator, and then I believe my solar fuses are 15 amp, but I will link all of these fuses in the description below. One thing I'm a little concerned about is the gauge of these wires. I have like 4 gauge running from my alternator, and I believe these wires are just 10 gauge. I might be trimming them back a little bit just to reduce that voltage loss, but they do give you quite a bit here, which is nice. I also think I'm gonna be connecting my wires directly together and not using those connectors that were provided. It'll just be a more secure connection.
So I have the new charger wired up here. I apologize, it looks like a bomb went off in my solar system. I don't have my inverter in charge because I recently picked up the new Renogy one, which I'm going to be doing a review on, so stay tuned for that. But my inverter used to be mounted here, and then I have my battery underneath. I just moved my battery over, and I'm going to need to relay out my solar system basically. But I took out the old charger, which was mounted in a similar spot, and I've installed the new one there. So let's go over the installation process and all the wiring. I already turned on my solar switch here, and I've hooked everything up, and I'm getting a red solar light on the side there, and then yellow light on the alternator battery. The default on the battery type was already lithium, which is represented by the blue. If I wanted to change that, you just click this type button right here. The yellow wire right here, I've connected to my solar, and I've just done kind of a quick connection here. And then the brown wire right here is connected to a 60 amp fuse, and this is like the positive out wire. So this is where all the power goes into the battery. Right here, this red wire, I have connected to my alternator. Finally, the negative, which is right here, also looks ridiculous because of the size of the wire, but this is my connection, and this goes to my negative bus bar. You might be wondering about the negative solar that comes from the solar panel, so that is also just connected to my negative bus bar. Oh, and then I have the temperature sensor just connected and hanging out right here. But the install is super easy. It's 4 wires, that's it.
Okay, let's jump into the app and connect to this thing and see the setting. To add the device, all you do is open the Renogy DC home app, click in the top right button on the plus icon, go add device, and then the device will pop up on your home screen here. So let's click on it. Okay, so we got battery type, lithium, system volts, 12, house battery volts, 13.6. House battery charging amps, house battery charging watts. Right now, we got a little bit from solar because it's pretty sunny out. Starter battery volts, 12.7. Starter battery amps, 0 amps. PV charging volts, PV charging amps. Total kilowatts generated. And then we got temperatures of the battery and the charger, which is really nice. Okay, so if we go up in the top right here, we can go history. So you can see like how much your battery's been charging on a daily basis, which is pretty nice to track if you're interested in that sort of thing. Okay, so here we got a whole bunch of settings. Maximum combined charging amps. Let's see what we can do here. Okay, so we can adjust it from 10 to 50, confirm. So if you have a battery that can't take 50 amps, you could adjust that to lower, or if you want to not pull so much from your alternator because maybe 50 is way too much for your alternator, you can adjust that as well. You got battery type, so you can probably do custom settings here, and then lithium, gel, sealed AGM, and flooded. Let's stay on lithium. Low solar current shutdown. This is what I'm so excited about. We can adjust this from 0 all the way up to 10 amps. Default was 7, so I'll probably put it down to 5. If it is 5 or less amps, it'll just shut down and pull all the energy from the alternator. Very nice feature. Lithium activation, that is for if your batteries are in shelf mode, it'll automatically kick them out of the activation, I believe. System volts 12, so you can switch from 24 to 12 to auto. Gonna keep it on 12 volts. Forward charging volts. I believe that setting is based on your alternator. Once it hits that voltage, it'll automatically start drawing from your alternator. So you don't wanna bring it down to 12 because then it'll just drain your starter battery and you'll be stuck without being able to drive anywhere. So be careful there. I would probably just keep it at probably 13.5. That's a pretty good voltage for an alternator. There's boost volts, so you can customize that. And then all the rest of these are based on your battery type. So if you wanted to customize these, they're all grayed out because I've just selected lithium, so it automatically selects them. So this is really nice, very customizable. I am very impressed with Renogy and what they've come out with here. The only thing is I'm a little concerned about the wire gauge coming out of that charger. I'm sure it'll probably be fine, but it's just a little different going from like a 4-gauge wire into like a 10-gauge wire. We'll see how that works out. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start the van up and see if we can pull some real amps into this thing. The van is running now. There is a 30-second delay before it will start pulling from the alternator, which is really nice. It doesn't just automatically start drawing all that current as soon as the vehicle starts up. Okay, so starter battery, 13.5 volts, 24 amps. So because we are getting 15 amps from solar, we're only gonna get pull a max of 25 amps from the alternator. But with this setting here, this low current shutdown, I'm actually gonna set this to 10 amps. So if that solar goes under 10 amps, we will start pulling 50 amps from the battery, which is a really nice feature. So I'm just gonna go back and shut down the solar and see how many amps we start drawing from the alternator. Okay, so solar shut off, and now we're pulling 38 amps from the alternator. I honestly thought it would be higher than that, but let's see. Oh, there it goes. Now it's popping up. So it's probably just based on the voltage. If that starter battery volt drops quite a bit, the controller will probably hold back on pulling so many amps from the starter battery, but 42 amps is pretty good. I'm sure if I was on the highway right now, we're just sitting idling. If I was on the highway right now, had those RPMs up, pulling a lot more, getting that higher voltage, I'm sure it'd be pulling closer to 50. That's typically what the other charger did as well. I'm very impressed with this product. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions about this DC to DC charger with MPPT, feel free to leave a comment below. I will get back to you as soon as I can. And if you found this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and share it if you know somebody else who's working on a solar system. And I will see you guys in the next one.